About 36 million people in the U.S. under excessive heat warnings due to a heat dome centered over California. That's roughly 10% of the U.S. population. Las Vegas on Sunday baked under record-breaking temperatures of up to 48 degrees Celsius. In the Death Valley National Park along the California-Nevada border, the National Weather Service projects extreme heat of 54 degrees Celsius until Friday. This comes after the world recorded its hottest June in history.
It is totally not a surprise to see the June record being broken after the May record having been broken after the April record. So we have had these 12 months of record hot month, which is because we have also record high levels of greenhouse gas emissions because of the burning of fossil fuels. These hot months mean hotter heat waves. It means much more heavy rainfall events with devastating floods as a consequence, which do violate the right to life, the right to housing, the right to a free culture and social and life for many, many people.
Heavy rains trigger flash floods and landslides in Nepal, killing at least 11 people. 8 are still missing, while 12 others were injured. Key highways and roads have been blocked, hampering rescue efforts. Landslides and flash floods are common in Nepal during the monsoon season, killing hundreds of people every year. In sports, the 2024 Palarong Pambansa all set to begin in Cebu City this Tuesday, with President Marcos and outgoing Education Chief Vice President Sara Duterte expected to attend the opening ceremonies. Annie Perez on the line now to tell us more about this. Annie, over to you.
Yes, that's right, Carmina. The biggest sporting event of the Department of Education, the Palarong Pambansa. They're already doing 3 activities here in Cebu City, its host city, in anticipation of its opening ceremony tomorrow. Yesterday, delegates and DepEd officials witnessed the ceremonial hoisting of the flags of all regions, including 2 new delegations this year, the Philippine Overseas Schools and the National Academy for Sport. Cebu City Acting Mayor Raymond Garcia said that the hosting of the city on the Palarong Pambansa is part of the Filipino spirit of resiliency and the never-say-die attitude. All the regional directors received tokens from the host city, and welcome dinners were also held last night. Meanwhile, DepEd Region 7 Director Salustiano Jimenez said that the Palarong Pambansa is a symbol of unity. DepEd, he says, is solidifying what they are aspiring for their young athletes, being always as one and always united. Over 15,000 student athletes are now in Cebu for the games of the Palarong Pambansa. They are billeted in the different schools within the city, with sporting venues spread throughout the highly urbanized cities of Mandaue and Lapu-Lapu City as well. Some athletes are already familiarizing with the venues by practicing days before their scheduled games. Tomorrow, Tuesday, July 9, the formal opening of the Palarong Pambansa will take place with President Bongbong Marcos Jr. and Vice President Sara Duterte as invited guests who have confirmed their attendance. Meanwhile, the city has been keen on monitoring market prices amid the influx of visitors. The local government unit has instructed all public markets that price increase of basic commodities are strictly prohibited. This includes meat, vegetables, and others, and that sanctions await violators. In terms of security, Carmina, over 2,000 police personnel are now deployed in different parts of Cebu along with force multipliers, and we are also set to await augmentation force as there are different visitors who are coming in the next 2 weeks. The Palarong Pambansa will officially close on July 16th, and this is the third time that Cebu City will be hosting this kind of event since its inception. And that's the latest here in Cebu City. Annie Perez, ABS-CBN News.
Thanks a lot, Annie Perez there.